Hi subscribers and viewers, welcome to Obi channel. So in this video I'm going to show you a practical way of how you can configure a CapsMan in MikroTik. So kindly sit back, relax and pay a rapt attention. Thank you. So let's proceed in the master router or the master access point and then configure our channels we are going to use in this CapsMan. And so the first thing to do is to create your channels, but in this case I'm using two frequencies, which is the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. So I'm going to create separate channels for these frequencies. So I'm creating for the first one, which is 2.4 GHz, and I create for the next one, which is 5 GHz. Okay, so this is 5 GHz. This is a channel for 5 GHz band. Okay, so the next one is to create data paths. So this is my first data path, or just a data path, which is okay. And then I select the bridge I'm going to use for the CapsMan. When you are done, just apply in okay. And then the next one, move to security configuration, which is here, and add a security configuration. So I term this as Ovi security. Okay, then you select the authentication type. I'm using this authentication type, encryption. I'm using this one, group encryption. Choose this, or you can choose any, but I'm choosing the first one. And then here you apply a password or a passphrase. So in this case I've typed my password. When you are done, click on apply and okay. We are not done. The next one is to move to configurations and add the configuration here. So this underscore OV, the mode, we say AP mode, right? Because that is the master. This part of the router is the master, which is going to control the slaves. So we put in an SSID here. Okay. The next one is to move to the channel and select the channel we created, one of them. If you select this one, it is 2.4. okay, go ahead and select the frequency. The next one is to move to the rates. There is nothing really to be done here, so just move to the data path and select the data path we created. And then the next thing is to select the bridge we are going to use for the CapsMan. The last thing to do is to select the security we created. Okay, you apply and okay. When you are done, move to provisioning. Under provisioning, you copy the radio MAC address of the slave. So in this case, this is my slave, right? So this is my slave. So this is my slave's MAC address, okay, for my wireless interface. Okay, yeah, you are really not going to see anything here. So this is the wireless interface of my slave. Okay, you put it here and then you select the action you create dynamic enabled, And the last thing to do is to under the master configuration, you select the Oubi. You apply and OK. And the last thing to do here is to come to Capsman interface under 8, you see manager, click on manager, open it and enable manager and OK. And the last thing you need to do reboot, click on caps mode and click on do not backup, so that when your slipped router is or access point is rebooted, it comes back in caps mode. And then when it's connected to your master capsman, you see it listed here that there is an active connection going on here. You see your radio here. So this is your slipped access point under capsman. Okay, so this is it. If you watch, so these are what we have under the capsman. So these are the basically the configuration you need to do to have a successful capsman. Okay, before I proceed, please do me a favor, subscribe to this channel, like my videos, share my videos, and kindly hit on the subscription notification so that you can have alerts from most of my videos. But then, we've come to the end of this video and I really hope you learned a lot on how to configure a capsman in MikroTik. Thank you again for watching.